The Committee of the Presidential Affairs has interfaced with six ministers implicated in the Karamoja Relief Iron Sheet saga, including Amos Lugolobi, Jacob Oboth, Matia Kasaija, Fred Bwino, Esther Anyakun and Jennifer Namuyangu, plus the youth MP for Central Uganda, Agnes Chirabo. They have faced the Presidential Affairs Committee to explain how they came to benefit from iron sheets meant for reformed cattle rustlers of Karamoja.
Return them back. I've so told you, I'm going to repeat. These iron sheets, I have wanted, the day when we finished, madam, you remember that committee, I wanted them to go back. When I sent it, I said, my personal assistant, said, go and get a vehicle and return. The boy went. When he went, he said, the storekeeper said, no, the place is locked. They have taken everything from here. So don't bring them. So what I do?
My first station to start working was in Karamoja, when no single lawyer in this country would want to go to. So the remorsefulness, where you would trade with your own life, for me to come and you say, now the way I'm talking, I am not remorseful. It is regrettable. That is remorsefulness enough.
Most ministers submitted they are innocent since they never solicited for the scandalous iron sheets. They noted they did not intend to take what belonged to the Karamajong.
Now I said that I really did not know that these were meant for the people of Karamoja. If I knew, perhaps I would not have taken them. So we actually discussed how to make good. And I had the initially, because we are saying we have to recover the iron sheets, then I said it does not make sense to recover the iron sheets because you will not use them anyway. So I said if I could know where these iron sheets were sourced, manufactured, I would be willing to buy and replace them.
Despite being remorseful, they vowed that they can't return the iron sheets, which they have already distributed to vulnerable people in their constituencies. They've thrown it back to the Minister of Karamoja Affairs, Mary Goretti Kitutu, to carry the cross.
Well, it was not in my plan for me, I can tell you. And if they had not given me, I would have not given out. Because for me, my program was different. This one had basically asked from OPM, and I knew they had a budget, they had iron sheets. So if I was given from a wrong source, they should be able to make good.
State Minister for Defense Jacob Maxons Oboth threatened to sue the Minister for Karamoja Affairs if anybody compels him to return the iron sheets. He says he has already suffered enough embarrassment.
And if there is need for me to refund this, it's 300 iron sheets. I can work for the next 6 months and raise that 18 million and I can refund it. But would be getting somebody else's poo-poo. Before I refund that, the person who led me to this, because I will sue that person.
I have never stolen anything in my life, including because our father said never steal. I have never stolen anything of anybody.
As the ministers were grilled, the State Minister for Relief and Disaster Preparedness, Esther Anyakun, revealed that the process for compilation of the names of final beneficiaries was marred with irregularities as all regional leaders acted like looters.
The list of the LC5s and their team was also its own. They were on the lot. The list submitted by the members of parliament, including myself, was not the right one. We are all on the lot. So if there was looting Karamoja, all the leaders were on the lot.
However, the Presidential Affairs Committee Chairperson, Jessica Ababiku, registered her disappointment with the under-fire Minister of Karamoja, Mary Goretti Kitutu, who has snubbed three committee summons since she last appeared earlier this month.
Yes, she requested for off-camera, and we have been following. Even this morning, I've been following. Can we find a way of getting Honourable Minister here so that we conclude this matter?
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.
Can we have our senior?